Now let us discuss vitiligo, which is acquired depigmentary disorder. Here the basic problem is the patients are going to have autoantibodies against melanocytes. So there will be autoantibodies against melanocytes. So there will be destruction of the melanocytes in few areas of the body, and it is usually associated with thyroid dysfunction, hypo or hyperthyroidism. So how does a patient present to a dermatologist? Chalky white, very, very white colored macules will be seen over the body. And the classification is, you can remember, this is important, okay? Segmental vitiligo, non-segmental vitiligo, and unclassified variant. So segmental was asked in the previous years. So in this segment, dermatomal, all these are the terms which can be used whenever we want to say that the lesions are unilateral and when they are not crossing the midline, not crossing the midline. So whenever you want to explain any condition which is only affecting one side of the body, and if it is not crossing the midline, and if it is arranged in a segment or dermatome, we use this term segmental, segmental. So in segmental vitiligo, we can see these chalky white macules over the body involving one side, which does not cross the midline. And this is going to be treated using surgical intervention. Why? Why? Because this is seen from the birth. And this segmental vitiligo is not going to respond to the medical treatments. This segmental vitiligo does not respond to medical treatments. So the usual topical agents or phototherapy which we give for non-segmental vitiligo will not work here because the lesions do not respond to medical treatment. Here in these patients, we have to do surgical intervention. What is a surgical intervention? We can perform a transplant, skin transplant from the thigh. We'll take the skin and we'll put it over a vitiligo lesion. So in the non-segmental variety, you can remember there are various types, but you can simply remember with the name, you can understand where the vitiligo lesions will be there. Acrofacial is face and acral areas. Extremities, the lesions will be there. Mucosal, next one is mucosal. So in mucosal, where can you see the lesions? Over the mucosa. And next we have vitiligo vulgaris. So this is the most common type of vitiligo which we can see, in which symmetrically distributed depigmented lesions will be seen all over the body. I will show you how the images of these will look like. And universal vitiligo, there will be almost entire body which is affected. In universal vitiligo, almost entire body will be affected. So this is the unclassified, undetermined variety of vitiligo, where over the body, okay, over the body, we can see few areas, one or two lesions of this hypo or depigmented pigmentation can be seen. This can be seen even in our body also. We need not worry about this. This is undetermined or unclassified variety. Unclassified variety, which is called as focal vitiligo. So here you can see in this image, this is acrofacial. Acro and facial, you can see over the acra means extremities, and over the face. Over the face, you are able to see this depigmented macules are present. And here you can see vitiligo vulgaris, most common variety where symmetrically distributed depigmented macules can be seen almost all over the body. And in the mucosal vitiligo, you can see mucosa having this whitish discoloration. And in universal vitiligo, I hope you all know who is this pop singer, pop dancer, God, king of pop, god of pop. Yes, Michael Jackson. So he had this problem of universal vitiligo. That means only one or two patches of this pigmentation can be seen over the body. One or two patches of normal skin will be seen over the body. So if you treat it, it will become completely white. There are treatments to make remove this few areas of normal skin which are remaining over the patients of universal vitiligo. So in vitiligo also, we can see true Koebner's phenomenon. This you all do know. And there is one more term, leukotrichia. What is leukotrichia? Leuko is white, trichia is hair. So not only skin, but also hair can become white in these patients. So hair follicle, melanocytes, if they are damaged and destroyed, then we can see that the hair can also become white. So along with the skin, you are able to see skin is white here. So this is an eyebrow picture. So eyebrows, you are able to see skin is white, and along with it, hair is also white. So this is what is called as leukotrichia. So what is this image showing? So this is the belt. The pressure of the belt is producing trauma, because of which there is Koebner's phenomenon. That is whitish discoloration of the skin seen over the traumatic area. So this patient was having vitiligo somewhere else over the body, but because of this trauma, vitiligo lesions have developed over this site. So this is true Koebner's phenomenon. So please try to answer this question in the 22-year-old college student with small depigmented lesions, which has been there for 2 years. So it is chronic condition, as you are able to see over the image. And you are in the image, you are able to see multiple depigmented patches and small macules are there. So this is a patient of, yes, wonderful, it is vitiligo. Okay. If the scalp was having white forelock, and along with that, if there are islands of normal skin. So if these two were there, then what would have been the answer? Yes, anybody? Wonderful. Then it would have been pyobaldism. But here you are able to see the areas of the skin is showing complete depigmentation it is vitiligo in this question.